something like this.
Right? It's crazy.
It's pretty cool.
Can we skip to the good part?
Hold on one sec, I'm gonna give the intro.
No, I'm gonna give the intro.
Okay, then do it.
Yo, what's up guys, it's Kyle. We are back with another video. We actually have a new person in the backseat.
What's up?
This is Josh. He is one of my students, actually, and I just asked if he wanted to come right along and get some other shots from the backseat. So first time flying with Josh, he's super excited, and we're super excited. We're going to Pinal today, which is an old airplane graveyard. It's about 50 miles to the south of where we are here, and basically, when COVID happened and all the airlines kind of lost a lot of business, they had to find a place to park all of these airliners that they weren't using anymore. And Pinal is one of the airparks that they were parking all these airplanes at. So we're going to go fly down there and check out the Boneyard.
I'm really excited about this flight just because whenever I go down to Pinal, it's always with students, but we really get to explore today. I really want to go show you all the cool different aircraft down there. Now, we can't get out of the airplane, but we can go taxi around and we'll get some really cool shots for you guys. So if you haven't already, give a like and subscribe to us. Every week we got new videos coming out of what it's like to come here as a student and also just fun adventures we do around here. So go ahead and give us a like, give us a subscribe, and tell us what you think the coolest airplane you see in the graveyard is today. All right, let's get going.
It'd be like Josh, come to UND Fitness.
Yeah, exactly.
Can we skip to the good part?
So you're from Florida, right?
From Florida, Fort Lauderdale.
Born and raised?
Born and raised.
Yeah. That's very different out here, isn't it?
Never thought I'd be traveling across the country to come here.
But here you are in a small airplane.
Here I am in a small airplane.
Yes, sir.
Heading to the graveyard.
Yes, sir. Heading to the graveyard.
With, of course, the best flight instructor in the world.
Flight instructors.
Oh, instructors.
True. Yeah, buddy.
We got two.
So Josh and I just started flight training together like 3 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And today is September 15th. He's supposed to be done with his private certificate by November 5th.
Oh, which bro, is you got insane. It.
How crazy is that, folks?
I know. So we fly together just about every day.
5 times a week, maybe yep. 6 times.
I just think it's a really cool opportunity, especially because, like, Josh already has a college degree. So why would he go to a school where they're doing flight training in conjunction with a college degree? Because he already has one. He doesn't need that. So he can just come here, knock out all of his pilot ratings super fast, and then get to an airline. So I think especially for people like him, it's a great option.
It's that's one thing that really separates us from a lot of other flight schools is a matter of like, we can offer the Aerospace Foundation down here. We offer a fast track program that is not connected to a degree. And we're probably one of the only 141 programs that does it like that. And again, great airplanes, great instructors, and just great training environment too. So, I mean, a lot of different places, you could not get a private pilot done in 2 months just because of weather, because of maintenance of a smaller operation. Down here, I mean, we have a lot of airplanes, 50 plus airplanes, I think, and it really does benefit you in Josh's position to get it done quickly.
And that is why I came here.
Yes, sir.
Because I am trying to start my career.
I think one of the other cool things about training down here is that there's so many cool airports around the Phoenix area. This is literally we've been flying for engine started till now 15 minutes, and we're only 20 minutes away from a really iconic airport that a lot of people in the aviation industry already know. You could go up to Sedona, what is that, 30 minutes away in the plane probably?
Yeah. 45? Yeah, 45.
Okay, yeah, you could go there, you could go down to Tucson, you could go down to Payson up north, Flagstaff, Page is only an hour and a half away. Yeah, Grand Canyon, actually. When Kyle and I were flying one time, we went to the Grand Canyon.
Go,
traffic 2686 is 5 miles to the north. We'll be entering the left downwind runway 30 Pinal.
Ground traffic is Starcraft 2040 is on a right crosswind for runway 30 Pinal.
Pinal traffic 2686, left base runway 30 Pinal. Pinal traffic 2686 on final runway 30 Pinal.
When I tell you, I have never seen anything like this.
Right? It's crazy.
It's pretty cool.
Pinal traffic 2686 is clear of runway 30, taxiing back to 30 on taxiway Alpha up now.
Just 747s after 747s.
Yeah, because they don't use them anymore.
Welcome to the Boneyard.
Oh my gosh. This is crazy.
It's so sad to see all these 747s all just scrapped. They're all getting retired now, and I remember when I was a kid going to Sky Harbor Airport and watching the British Airways 747 come in and land, and it was always my dream as a little kid to fly it, but it looks like that won't be happening. I'll have to settle for, like, I don't know, the 787 or 777 or something, which, you know, still pretty cool, but...
I always think about how many stories these airplanes must have went through. Like, think about all the moments shared on these airplanes.
That's exactly what I was thinking, too. Just the memories of, I mean, that's crazy.
All the storms, all the oceans that they crossed.
How many people they transported, how many loved ones people saw because of these planes. Oh, look at that. Corsair.
That's crazy.
Dude, I could spend like an hour and a half here.
Oh, I know.
That is one funky looking airplane. So what is the Dream Lifter?
It's an airplane that is a lot like a 747, but it was modified a little bit.
Yeah,
and Boeing uses it. I think they use it to fly like...
airport parts.
Yeah, like airplane parts to their different factories, because they have a couple different factories around the world.
So they still use that?
Yeah, they do still use that.
Okay.
I think there are like 4 or 6 of them or something that they made?
Yeah, so they transport wings, they transport fuselages, stuff like that.
Pinal traffic, Su 686 taking 30 and departing to the north, Pinal.
All right, guys, so that is going to be it for the video. I'm really happy that you guys got to see all these amazing things like the Pinal Air Park. We showed you what it's like to fly in the mountains so far. We're going to go show you what it's like to fly in Sedona soon. Josh, did you have a fun time?
Oh, amazing.
Yeah.
You guys better come here.
Yeah.
You
heard it from him.
You heard it from me first.
It's a lot of fun down here.
It is a lot of fun. It is an experience you will not gain anywhere else.
And maybe Kai and I could even take you on a flight one time.
Yeah, I think we're taking one a flight right now.
Yeah, that's true. That is true. But in person, right?
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, we're super happy that you guys came along with us on this trip. I think we're going to end it again with our little time-lapse video going back into Gateway. See what kind of landing I have today. Last video was not great.
Can I get the landing today?
Sure, you want it?
Yeah, I want the landing today.
All right, but we will see you guys in the next video. We hope you had a good time, and it was fun flying with Josh. Let us know if we should keep on bringing him, because, you know,
yeah,
if you guys
know,
like him,
comments.
we'll keep bringing him.
I think if we
like
could
and subscribe.
Josh.
The more likes and subscribes,
yeah,
subscribe,
more.
That means, yeah.
Right, if we get 75 likes, we'll bring Josh.
Okay.
No, let's say, okay, let's be realistic. We're just growing the channel. Let's say 15 likes, and we'll bring Josh along to the next video.
Okay, we're gonna cut that. That sounds sad.
Okay. If we get enough likes, we're going to bring Josh on the next video, okay?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Whatever that might be. All right, guys. We'll see you next time. Peace.
Peace.